A rare threatened liana means buddhi climber of shivaliks. Well known to locals in Jammu as Mal Kangani. Very important woody vine, woody climber. Known variously in Sanskrit as Jyotishmati, Paravatpadi, Kakandki, Kangunika, Peetatela, Katvika, Vega, Katvhi. Peetatela is because it has the yellowish colored, yellowish orange oil, seed oil. This is also called as Kakandki. Kaka means crow. Crows seed look like small fleshy egg like. In Hindi it is also known as in Uttarakhand Kauniya or Mal Tangun or Mal Kauni. In Dogri, especially in Ramnagar area, it is also known as Sankhire di Bel. In English it is called as intellect tree. Why intellect tree? Because its seeds are used, seed oil is used for enhancing the memory. It is used to treat the nervous problems. It sharpens memory. So it is also known as intellect vine, intellect liana. It is also known as stoff tree because its woody stems are also used as stoff by the locals. It is also known as black oil tree, black oil liana, because the seed oil is of two colors. It depends how you process it and what ingredients you add. It can be of yellow orange color or it can be black. So that got its another name, black oil tree. Also is climbing stoff tree. In Odia it is known as Katopesu, whereas in Assamese language it is known as Pokitai. In Kannad it is called Kariganne. In Tamil it is called as Adivaricham or Velulobai. Telugu it is Bambzi. In Bengali Lata Fatki. Why Lata Fatki? Because it's a climber Lata Fatki, because its fruits get fruit, basically they are capsules and they are break open to expose the red arid seeds. Seeds are not red, but fleshy covering outside the seed, as we find even in nutmeg or even in Texas valichiana. So that aril is red. But this is exposed when the capsules are split open. So it is called Lata Fatki. In Nepali, it is also known as Ihoro. Marathi language, Mal Kongani. In Punjabi, it is called Sankhu. And in Dogri, also Sankhire di Bel. Malayalam, it is Cherupunna or Valulobam. Arabic language. In Arabic language, we call it as Habbe Kilkil. Whereas in Persian, it is known as Kaul. This is a very important Ayurvedic woody liana found in our Jammu Shivaliks. And the oil is available in the market under the name Jyotishmati oil. This particular medicinal climber is rare. It is declining in our Jammu Shivaliks because of land use changes, over exploitation, even forest fire incidences, and poor regeneration. Mostly the male and female flowers grow on separate plants. But as per the Ayurvedic inputs, it is used for headache, for the treatment of ophthalmic diseases, for lung infection, gastric disorders, pile treatment and fistula treatment. It is also useful to cure the urinary troubles, menstrual disorders, impotency. It is very unique to treat impotency. This plant is employed by the Ayurvedic practitioners. Very important to deal with arthritis. Mal Kangani is very useful for arthritis. for as a pain killer. This is also useful for wound healing, also useful in leprosy. That is the beauty of this particular plant, and many other eczema, skin disorders. This particular plant has been used even for the drug addicts, especially against the opium poisoning. If someone is addicted to opium, Papaver somniferum, that gummy exudate, which gives hallucination kind of thing, that drug. So if you want to get rid of that menace, then you can recommend the leaf extract. The leaf juice can be given to the victim so that he is able to leave the opium addiction. So this is the beauty. As compared to our Indian intellect wine, which is Celastrus paniculatus, which foliage turns golden yellow during autumn season, so it is very useful to include it even in our floriculture parks and gardens for as a decorative climber, along with scarlet red, aril of the seeds, which gets exposed, and again it adds color to the background of golden yellow foliage. So this is a decorative plant, especially in America. For this ornamental value, another species, Asian bittersweet, also known as Chinese bittersweet, also known as a round-leaved bittersweet. Bittersweet because there is another solanum, Dulcamara, which is also known by this bittersweet. So its fruit looked like that. So named as bittersweet. So this is basically a Chinese liana, not native to America, but this was taken in 1879 to America as a decorative ornamental plant to decorate parks and gardens. But over the years it has naturalized and it has gone invasive. It has invaded the land. Now it is proving a headache. The native US species is basically, which is there, that is Scandens. Celastrus scandens is native, whereas Celastrus arbiculatus, round-leaved bittersweet, it is native to China, but introduced in US. But its seeds are poisonous, so not fit for the consumption of humans, whereas wildlife, especially the birds, they get fascinated with the red aril and get attracted, and they eat without any harmful impact on their metabolism. So this is useful to attract birds, and golden yellow foliage along with this red split capsules, it adds color and charm to the beauty, but otherwise it is not medicinal, it is not that useful as our Indian Celastrus paniculatus, Jyotishmati or Malkangani. The native species of Celastrus, which is Scandens, is again a liana. It is also known as American bittersweet. Its roots are medicinal, which were once used by the local natives to treat the venereal diseases and even to treat the tuberculosis. And this particular native liana, Celastrus Scandens, is being displaced by the more competitor taxa, introduced one, that is Celastrus arbiculatus. Why arbiculatus is able to compete much better? Because it develops the mycorrhizal association in the roots, which help in better phosphorus absorption for the plant. One. Second, this is able to withstand even higher rainfall conditions. Where there is a higher rainfall, it colonizes well. Seeds, because they have the red aril, they are eaten by the birds, and birds go here and there roam, and then they scatter the seeds, and then germination takes place, and it has gone invasive. This particular plant has also the gone invasive in area like Georgia to Wisconsin. And apart from the decorative value, it is proving a nuisance and it is displacing the local flora. But our native, our Indian, our Himalayan plant, which is also found in South India, is very useful, very medicinal, and is in the endangered category, and it need to be included in our herbal gardens, even our botanical gardens, parson gardens maintained by floriculture, so that this particular liana